Located near the equator in both hemispheres, the Galapagos penguin is the northernmost penguin species in the world, and the only penguin to nest entirely within the tropics. Galapagos penguins are endemic to the Galapagos Islands, meaning that they are found nowhere else in the world. Their habitat is restricted to very specific areas of the Galapagos flushed by cold, nutrient-rich upwelling currents that allow for a high density of prey. The majority of the population can be sighted on or near the volcanic rocks bordering the islands of Isabela and Fernandina. However, they are also located around the islands of Floriana, Santiago, and Bartolome. The cold Humboldt Current runs along the South American coast and swings westward as it approaches the equator. The current remains cool even when reaching the Galapagos. The Cromwell Current is a slow, deep, cold current that flows east and upwells at the western part of the islands when it runs up against the Galapagos Plateau. One of the closest relatives to the Galapagos penguin is the Humboldt penguin that inhabits the western coast of South America. The ancestors of today's Galapagos penguins are thought to have been carried by the westward flowing Humboldt Current to the Galapagos, where they found suitable habitat, abundant with food. Galapagos penguins are patterned in black and white. On the side of their head, a narrow white line of feathers extends from behind the eye and curves around to the throat. There is a dark band on their white breast that extends down both sides of their body. Typically only standing around 20 inches tall, Galapagos penguins are some of the smallest penguins in the world. Males are generally larger and slightly heavier than females. Due to their restricted range and fluctuating population size, Galapagos penguins are listed as endangered. They are often negatively impacted by El Niño events, where the resulting high sea temperatures cause small schooling fish to disperse, and the penguins are left with little food. There was a particularly severe El Niño event from 1982 to 1983 that caused a large portion of the population to starve. A census taken by the Charles Darwin Foundation in 2020 counted 1,940 penguins, which is the most penguins recorded since 2006. Galapagos penguins spend much of their time preening, as their feathers and down have extremely important insulating properties. They usually molt before breeding. During the molting period, they fast, as they cannot keep their body properly warm in the water while molting. Typically after 10 to 15 days, a molting penguin resumes its normal life. Galapagos penguins are opportunistic breeders. They are capable of laying eggs up to 3 times in a good year, or in times of food scarcity, they may not breed that year at all. Breeding is most frequent in the cool, dry season. The penguins typically form pair bonds and mate for life. Each female lays 1 or 2 eggs in a cave or crevice in order to keep the eggs out of the sun. The nest may consist of sticks, feathers, bones, and leaves that the penguins have brought to cover the rough bottom of the cave or crevice. One parent will always stay with the eggs while the other will be gone for several days to feed. The parents take turns at this for 35 to 40 days, after which the dark, fluffy, down-covered chicks appear. The parents take turns caring for their chicks. Chicks molt, get their adult feathers, and are on their own in about 8 to 9 weeks. They can live about 20 years. Another reason for their endangered status is the lack of suitable nesting sites. So in 2010, a biologist and her team built 120 high-quality, artificial Galapagos penguin nest sites for them to use. Monitoring trips since then indicate that penguins have been putting the nest to good use. Galapagos penguins forage close to shore and at relatively shallow depths. They prey mainly on nearshore schooling fish like mullet and sardines. Some crustaceans are taken as well. They forage during the day alone or in small groups. They can travel quickly through the water. Dives are short, generally less than a minute, but can last for more than 3 minutes. Predation in the water seems to be insignificant, but sharks, fur seals, and sea lions are potential threats. Swimming in the cool ocean is also how Galapagos penguins keep cool. On land, they protect their feet from sunburn by holding their flippers over their feet. They will also pant when necessary to cool down, or hold their flippers out. For more marine facts, click the subscribe button.